Mimi's got almost a full squad, and Krusty's clown has at least two to fix.
Yeah. Yeah, so looks like Mama's got, well, I take it back. Am I looking at the right one here? Son of a gun, did I grab the wrong one?
Braille Bombers and Krusty's Clown College.
Oh, I got it here, but they're like missing a son of a gun. Sorry, I'm all jacked up here. This is what happened.
What did you do today? Maybe if you didn't race out the door at 4 with your sport coat flailing in the wind,
you know, jerk,
these things off.
You know, it was a problem because I wasn't racing in the sport coat, but I was racing to a beer bash, so I had to get there quickly. So she gets back Andrew Luck, who I'm sure she's very happy about. Golden Tate should have a big day. Jerick McKinnon, we'll see if he does anything for Minnesota, I don't know. On the other side, Cam Newton hasn't always been his starter then, right? He may change out Cam, because I'm trying to remember who his starter is normally. Do you know? You don't know.
Krusty's Clown?
Yes.
I'll tell you right now. It is...
He's going to have Emmanuel...
Phil Rivers. Yes,
yeah.
Phil Rivers.
So Phil gets back, so at least it'll be a good matchup between Luck and Rivers. Not that they're playing each other, but I mean that it'll be a good matchup to see those two go against it. I think it's going to come down to some of Krusty's, secondary players, but the ones who haven't been helping. We'll see what Ronnie Hillman can do. Maybe he'll have a big day for Denver going up against St. Louis. So I'm giving the edge to my mom simply because she's been on a tear. I don't see anybody stopping her yet. But who knows? Maybe he'll reach up from the grave and snatch a victory away just to push my mom closer to Dawn in a 7-and-whatever record? 7-3.
7-3. Speaking of that, maybe my favorite game of the week, which I will be in Nashville, ironically enjoying the heat in November. I didn't think I'd say that. But I will be there in my hotel room, clutched to my laptop, working on school or the review, and watching the game closely from afar, because she plays the worst team ever.
Yeah, baby, it is on. It is so on. I so wish she'd get a sitter and show up to the event just so I could yell at her in person. I may have to call her during the game. So we got Aaron Rodgers against Philadelphia. Wow, that's going to either be a shootout or some low-scoring game, I'm predicting. You got Antonio Brown again. Antonio Brown and Martavis Bryant against Tennessee. Come on, I need you guys this week. Jimmy Graham against Cincinnati, who's looking for a bounce back. I think it's going to be all right, hopefully, because they're in New Orleans versus being in Cincinnati, and Randall Cobb against Philly. I'm liking that. On the other side of the ledger, we got Jay Cutler, who's been Jekyll and Hyde, right? I mean, he's had some good games, but not some so good games either. So,
well, don't forget, I don't know what his bye is, but she also has Brady.
Yeah, does she start him? I don't know. Does she start Brady or Forge Cutler? She loves her Cutler-Forte matchup. I think she's intrigued by that. Forte looks to have a good day against Minnesota. We got Julio Jones at Carolina. That should be a good day for him. And Eddie Lacy against Philadelphia. So we're going to be rooting in a lot of the same games because we share a lot of players here. But it's going to be a good matchup. It's going to come down to the wire. I'm predicting a big scoring game. So I think that goes to anybody. I'm excited.
Yeah, even without any movement with Brady, it's projecting a close one, 154 to 148.
Yep.
All right, the next one is the punishment due, another one of your, to half this league is a nemesis of yours, punishment due versus the Mouseketeers. Punishment due coming off a win, Mouseketeers looking for another one. That one looks to be another close, tough one.
Yeah, the punishment due and Mouseketeers. Peyton Manning looking to continue his streak. Andy Dalton, will Red get it back against New Orleans? I think the game, yep, it's in New Orleans. So I'm sure Andy Dalton's going to play better than he did with his -3. I don't predict a negative number for Andy Dalton this week. But they're loving Peyton Manning. So I think the edge goes to the Mouseketeers. She's got A.J. Green back. Again, that's kind of going counter to my Andy Dalton thing, but I'm thinking A.J. Green will get his. Mike Evans, will he continue to impress? I don't know. Jared Cook was another one that gave me a few heart attacks there with that long touchdown pass in St. Louis. On the other side, Todd's got Marshawn Lynch, beast mode. But, you know, I think I'm definitely rooting for your sister here just because I want her to knock Todd down to size. But I'm thinking Todd might be due for a loss here. He's cut it too close to the razor's edge. It's time for him to fall off. Who's next?
All right. And then we've got a battle of two man crushes for me. Jason versus
Man
Clemens,
crushes.
The Ralph Wiggum Experience, and the Rockland Smashers. It's got Ralph Wiggum projected to score 162. They obviously like his team. Rockland projected 131 bye. That's misleading because he does have at least one bye issue in there.
Yeah.
The issue being he wants to meet a bye.
What does that even mean, you freak? Yeah, so Ralph Wiggum, I don't think Tannehill's his normal quarterback. I think it's somebody else, right? Romo, obviously. Yeah, Romo. Yeah, although Romo. He has Tannehill in now. That'd be really funny if he didn't play Tannehill over Romo. I'd be very interested to see if he does that.
Tannehill looks good, too.
I know, and maybe he does. Maybe he likes him against Buffalo. Boy, that would be a gamble. How funny would it be if he started Tannehill and he tanked while Romo went off on his bench? I got Jeremy Maclin and Calvin Johnson predicted for 21 apiece. Kelvin Benjamin for another 20. On the opposite side, oh, man, Eli Manning. Who else do you have? Tell me he's got a better quarterback than that. Who's injured. Wait, he has a quarterback that's injured, right? Does Rockland have a...
Well, what I was going to say is, speaking of Jason Text, I think he's trying to make a trade with Donna, and I tried reaching out to him on Sunday, but she's definitely interested. If you're watching...
I'm sure he will be. All right, then we got LeSean McCoy against Green Bay. Will Shady get his numbers? Who the heck knows? It's been up and down, and I'm not so sad that Shady's had a bad year since Sproles has had a nice one so far. Jordy Nelson against Philly, he should get his. Martellus Bennett looks to bounce back, and Mike Wallace looks to have a big day against Buffalo. Maybe that's why he's got Tannehill going. Who knows? Maybe he wants a little man-on-man action there between Tannehill and Wallace. Who'll get the better of that? In this one, obviously I'm going for the Mouseketeers. Rockland Smashers, check that over, Jason, for two reasons. One, I'd love to see Sean Connery beat him, but secondly, it's going to help me in my standings. Next up.
Okay. Next and last, we've got the Wild Poopers going up against the newly renamed De Nada. It's right now, it's hard to tell because Wild Poopers only show 7, but she's projected to get 102. Team De Nada has to look at their lineup because it's got 10 full. His roster's full with 10 people, but it's only projected at 95.
Yeah, they are definitely predicting a bad day for De Nada. You gotta hate it when your opponent doesn't even have their full squad and they're already beating you. She got Drew Brees, obviously, against Cincinnati. He's gonna have a big day. Sammy Watkins, again, it's gonna be between he and Kelvin Benjamin. See, who's the rookie pickup of the year, I believe. Then you got Julius Thomas, about 16. Please, he's gonna blow that number out of the water. And Larry the Legend. Larry the Legend's always up and down, so I don't always count him as he's gonna have his day. Matthew Stafford against Arizona. This will be interesting because it's going to be in Arizona without Carson Palmer, as you said, although it's going to be their defense, who has been getting torched lately. So I think Stafford could have a bigger day than that. And Andre Ellington in Arizona, will he flourish like he did under Carson Palmer? He had great days under Palmer. Will he have the same understanding? I do not know. And Pierre Garçon against Tampa Bay could be another shootout down there. I like the Wild Poopers in this one, but who knows? Maybe De Nada gets his third win. It's going to be up to anybody. And as they say, on any given Sunday, who knows?
Yep. Well, that's it for week 11. We talked about standings. Again, you already talked about your big get-together this weekend, so have a good time, everyone. I will be definitely missing the event and Don's head hanging over a mayonnaise jar like last year.
That's what we need to do. We need to take a picture of an empty mayonnaise jar there and send that to Don on Sunday.
I have it. No, I have one of her last year. I'll send it.
Make sure you send that out. That'd be a good one. All right, so everybody, take care. Kevin, stay warm in the cold, wintry gales of Idaho.
80% chance of snow tomorrow.
Now you got to take some pictures, right? Or a little video of some snow? All right, please do that. And we'll see everybody Sunday at Republic. Good luck, everybody. Safe travels, Kev.
Thank you.
Have fun in your hotel, but not too much fun. And we will see you next week. So for Kevin Heath, this is Matt Diggy saying, set your lineup, slackers. Kev, take us out.
Stay classy, Bone Storm.